Hey guys, welcome back. So I've been getting so many messages related to this topic and I could not answer each and every message, so I decided to create a video on this step by step guide to become a data engineer. I will divide this video into three different parts. The goal of these videos is to tell you why you need to learn these skills and what's the real world use case of it. Most of the time we look some guide or path to learn these skills, but deep down we don't even know why we are learning this skill. So in my first three part I will explain you why you need to learn these skills and what's the real world use case behind it. So that way you will have clear understanding about these things you are learning and you will be motivated enough to complete the entire path. So in the first part we will talk about the beginner and the fundamental skills required to become a data engineer. So if you have zero knowledge and experience, then you can start from here. In the second part of this video we will talk about some intermediate skills required to become a data engineer. This part is for those people that have 1 to 2 years of working experience in this field and they know some fundamentals already. In the third and the final part of this video, we will talk about some advanced level skills to become a data engineer. This part is for those people that have 3 to 4 years of working experience and want to advance their career. After these 3 parts, I will create one more video where I will list down everything you need to know in single video. So in case in future if you want quick recap, you can watch that video. I will also share some resources and links in the description so you can learn these skills. And you can jump to the required section by clicking on timestamp, but I will suggest watch this video till the end and take notes while you're watching it. You can take notes on any paper or Word document for your future reference, so let's get started. In the first part, as I said, I will assume that you have zero understanding of this field and are just getting started, or you might be working on a different field and want to switch your career into data engineering. This section is all about getting your fundamentals strong. Number one mistake people make when they get into data industry is that they don't focus on the fundamentals of computer science and analytics. They just start learning different tools and big technologies and give up after few weeks because they don't understand how these things are connected. Number one skill you need to learn is programming language. As a data engineer, you will be writing code to read, write or transform data. This can be done by using some tools or writing code. Top 3 programming languages used by data engineers are Python, Java and Scala. If you already know one language from this list, then you are in good position. If you don't know any programming language, then you can start with Python. Python is really easy to learn and many companies are shifting to Python as it supports many libraries and packages that makes things really easy. Things you need to learn in Python are basic syntax, data types, learning how to work with lists, sets, loops, operators, reading and writing different files such as CSV, JSON, Excel, etc. I will tell you about the libraries you need to learn in further part of this video. As you learn programming language, you will also need to learn basic data structures. What is data structure? Data structure is the way computer organizes data so it can be used effectively. For example, when you are going out for a long trip and while packaging your bag, you make sure you organize things properly so that you can fit as many as things you want. But if you start putting things randomly, then you might not be able to put everything in one single bag. This is exactly why you need to know the data structures. You don't need to learn some advanced level data structures, but you need to get your fundamentals straight. There are 2 reasons for learning data structures. Number one is for interviews. Many companies will test your data structure knowledge in the interview. They might ask you some coding questions, or in the face-to-face technical interview, they might check your fundamental knowledge of computer science. And the second reason is that you will be working with a large amount of data and processing large data takes time. Understanding of the data structure will help you to write fast and efficient code. Things you need to learn in data structures are arrays, linked lists, stack, queue, graph and trees, plus some sorting and searching algorithms. Number 3 on the list is learning about fundamentals of databases. There are different types of databases that are available in the market. As a beginner, you just need to learn about the relational databases. Relational databases stores data into proper structure in rows and columns, just like an Excel file, so it makes easier to read, write and update data. Things you need to learn in databases is how to create, update and delete tables, how to insert data in tables. These operations are known as data definition language, DDL, data control language, DCL and data manipulation language, DML. You will also need to learn how to create database schema, creating index, what are ACID properties, creating views, stored procedure, what is normalization, creating data models and ER diagrams, etc. Number 4th on the list is learning SQL or structured query language. you will learn SQL while you are learning database fundamentals. So step 3 and step 4 are connected together. Being a data engineer, you will be dealing with lots of data, and SQL is how you communicate with databases. SQL is a must-have skills for data engineers because the goal of data is to create value for the businesses, and using SQL you can pull required data by applying some business logic on top of it and visualize it so that business people can keep track of how things are performing. Things you need to learn in SQL are again how to read, update and insert data, how to join tables, how to write subqueries, how to use group by and having clause, case statement, window functions, aggregation functions such as count, sum, max, mean, etc. and casting values into different types. There are many database management tools available in the market. You just need to learn one and you will understand most of the things. You can either start with the MySQL or PostgreSQL. Both are open source and have many similarities too. Till now we only talked about the beginner and the fundamental skills to become a data engineer. In the next video, we will talk about some intermediate skills required to become a data engineer, such as knowing big data fundamentals, what are the tools and skills are required to become one. If you learned something new from this video, then don't forget to share it with your friends. And if you want to support my work, then you can like and subscribe to this channel. This will help the YouTube algorithm to recommend this content to more and more people. Thank you.